Amen. Good morning, family. You ready to hear the word of God this morning?
¿Listos para escuchar la palabra de Dios esta mañana?
Amen. So, if you notice, I got a translator beside me right here.
Como se dieron cuenta, tenemos un traductor esta mañana.
I got to catch on, amen.
Que necesita que le arreglen el micrófono.
So, prayerfully, God has some grace on Omar today.
Ojalá y Dios tenga una gracia para Omar esta mañana, amen.
Because sometimes when the Spirit takes over,
porque a veces cuando el Espíritu se encarga y agarra el volante,
you just keep going.
Tú tienes que seguir adelante.
Open up your Holy Scriptures with me.
Abran las Escrituras en
to Mateo. I might go in and out here, amen.
Amen.
To Matthew chapter 13.
Mateo 13.
In verse 44.
13:44.
To 46.
Al 46.
The Bible reads, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure hidden in a field. When a man found it, he hid it again, and then in his joy went and sold all he had and bought that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant looking for fine pearls. When he found one of great value, he went away and sold everything he had and bought it." You know, the scriptures right here teaches us that the kingdom of heaven is like a treasure.
La Biblia aquí nos enseña que el reino de los Dios es como un tesoro.
And that the kingdom of heaven is something that when this person found it, it was of great value.
Y que el reino de los cielos es algo tan importante. Y cuando este hombre lo encontró, se dio cuenta de que era de gran valor.
But you know, when I think of great treasure, I think of treasure hunters.
Pero cuando me pongo a pensar en grandes tesoros, me pongo a pensar en las personas que buscan esos tesoros.
And I know as a child, I was a treasure hunter.
Yo como un niño me gustaba buscar siempre tesoros.
I wanted to find the most valuable things. I wanted to find the things that nobody found before.
Quería buscar las cosas de más valor, las cosas que nadie antes había encontrado.
And the treasures that I used to seek the most with all my heart.
Y el tesoro que yo buscaba con todo mi corazón.
Were those good old McDonald's toys.
Eran las hamburguesas de McDonald's.
Because you never knew what you were going to get in the Happy Meal.
Bueno, el Happy Meal del McDonald's, porque nunca sabes qué va a haber adentro de esa cajita feliz.
Because it's not called a Happy Meal for no reason.
¿Por qué no le dicen cajita feliz por ninguna razón, verdad?
Because it has a great treasure in the box right there, amen.
Porque tiene un increíble tesoro adentro de esa cajita.
But you know the greatest treasure that we can have in the kingdom of God.
Pero sabes, el tesoro más grande que podemos tener en el reino de Dios
is Jesus our Lord and Savior.
Es Jesucristo nuestro Señor y Salvador.
But the scripture, it says that when this man found the treasure,
pero la escritura dice que cuando este hombre encontró el tesoro,
he hid it and in his joy,
dice que lo escondió y en su alegría,
went and sold everything.
Fue y vendió todo.
You see, joy is different from happiness.
Sí, el gozo es diferente a la felicidad.
Joy in the Bible is an attitude of the heart.
El gozo en la Biblia es una actitud del corazón.
That is consistent.
Que es consistente.
That is stable.
Que es estable.
And that is steadfast.
Y que se será siempre firme.
Proverbs chapter 10, verse 24.
Proverbios 10, 24.
Says, "What the wicked dreads will overtake him. What the righteous desire will be granted." And yet the Bible calls us and it teaches us that the world is not our treasure.
La Biblia nos llama y nos dice que el mundo no es nuestro tesoro.
And when the kingdom of God and when Jesus is not your treasure,
y que cuando el reino de Dios y Jesús no es tu tesoro,
you must expect a life of dread.
Tú tienes que esperar una vida muy difícil.
And so the title of my lesson this morning,
so el título de la lección esta mañana,
is "Open Your Treasure Chest."
Es abre el baúl de tus tesoros.
We're going to look at today this morning what kind of treasures did Jesus leave us here on the earth?
So vamos a ver y vamos a ver qué tipo de tesoro nos dejó Dios aquí en la tierra.
Point number one.
Punto número uno.
Embrace the treasure of Christ.
Agarra el tesoro de Jesucristo.
Treasure is defined as something of great worth or value.
Un tesoro se define como algo de gran valor.
It's also defined as a person esteemed as rare, of precious collections or precious things.
O también se define como una persona o algo que es muy raro y muy especial.
And yet the treasure that Christ has left us is He Himself.
Pero el tesoro que Jesús nos dejó fue a Él mismo.
Through His love.
Por medio de su amor.
Turn with me to Ephesians.
Vámonos a Efesios, chapter 1. Capítulo 1.
Because when you look at your life as a disciple,
cuando tú ves tu vida como discípulo,
and to really think and see, okay, I am here because of Jesus' sacrifice.
Y sabes que estás aquí por el sacrificio de Jesucristo.
That's pretty crazy.
Eso es una locura.
The love of Christ is yet the greatest treasure.
El amor de Jesucristo es el gran tesoro que nos dio. Este que somos como tenemos como discípulos.
And there has to be something about this sacrifice.
Tiene que haber algo en el sacrificio de Jesucristo.
That has brought you here this morning.
Que te ha traído aquí esta mañana.
Ephesians chapter 1, verse 3.
Efesios 1:3.
Through 9.
Del 3 al 9.
Praise be to the God of the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in the heavenly realms with every spiritual blessing in Christ. For He chose us in Him before the creation of the world to be holy and blameless in His sight. In love, He predestined us to be adopted as His sons through Christ Jesus in accordance with His pleasure and will. In the Bible right here in Ephesians 1,
la Biblia aquí nos dice en Efesios 1,
it referenced the word blessed 3 times.
Utiliza la palabra bendición 3 veces.
Some of your versions might have started off and said, praise be to God.
Algunas versiones empezaron ustedes como diciendo, alabándose a Dios.
But in verse 3 it says, praise be to God, who has blessed us and who has given us every spiritual blessing in Christ Jesus.
Pero como vamos a ver en versículo 13, dice, alabado sea Dios, Padre de nuestro Señor Jesucristo, que nos ha bendecido en las regiones celestiales.
Praise be means praise be, amen.
Alabado sea significa alabado sea Dios, amén.
But blessed means to bestow a special favor.
Pero el ser bendecido es tener esa bendición contigo constantemente.
And blessings mean a generous gift.
Y las bendiciones son un regalo en abundancia.
And because the Bible references this 3 times, the Bible is saying this is very significant.
Pero porque la Biblia hace referencia a esto 3 veces, eso nos indica que esto es muy importante.
That in the Greek, the words are closely related.
Porque en el griego las palabras se juntan mucho.
Which gives us the understanding of the point in which Paul is trying to make.
Para darnos el entendimiento del punto que nos quiere dar a entender Pablo.
What Paul has written here from verses 3 through 14,
lo que está hablando Pablo aquí del versículo 3 al 14,
is a description of praise to God.
Es la descripción de la alabanza hacia Dios.
In one sentence in the Greek, there is 202 words in this passage.
En una oración en el griego hay 243 versículos o palabras en esta oración.
And as you read this verse, you begin to see that, man, this was a treasure chest for Paul.
Cuando al leer estas escrituras podemos ver que era un baúl lleno de tesoros para Pablo.
That you can imagine Paul sticking his hands in this treasure chest and the jewels coming up to his face and him being so fired up.
Imagínense a Pablo como que abrió el baúl del tesoro y que metió sus manos y sacó esas ollas que son esas joyas que son las escrituras que podemos ver aquí.
To have them in his presence.
Al tenerlas en su presencia.
Let's pick it up in verse 6.
Vamos al versículo 6.
To the praise of His glorious grace, which He has freely given us in the one He loves, and in we have redemption through His blood, the forgiveness of sins, in accordance with the riches of God's grace, that He lavished us with all wisdom and understanding, and He made known to us the mystery of His will according to His good pleasure, which He purposed in Christ. Paul right here shows us what this treasure chest is.
Aquí Pablo nos muestra lo que es este tesoro.
And when you understand this treasure chest of jewels and of love and incredible spiritual blessings,
y tú cuando entiendes que este baúl está lleno de tesoros, de felicidad, de cosas increíbles,
you will think highly of God.
Tú vas a pensar aún mucho más grande, vas a tener una gran apreciación hacia Dios.
And when you think highly of God, you praise Him for who He is. Amen.
Cuando tú sabes que Dios es increíble, lo alabas por lo que Él realmente es.
If you think little of God,
si tú piensas que Jesús es algo pequeño, que Dios es algo pequeño,
and what He's done for you,
y que lo que ha hecho por ti,
you will do very little for Him.
Tú vas a hacer poco por Él.
But let's take a look at this treasure chest of Christ.
Pero veamos este baúl de tesoros de Jesucristo.
Paul says that we were chosen, we were predestined.
Pablo dice que nosotros fuimos predestinados
to be disciples.
Para ser discípulos.
He says you were adopted.
Dice, tú fuiste adoptado
to be in His kingdom.
Para estar en su reino.
And He says you have redemption through the forgiveness of sins.
Tú has sido redimido para el perdón de pecados.
Because of Jesus' sacrifice.
Por el sacrificio de Jesucristo.
You know, redemption means release from slavery.
La redención es ser liberado de la esclavitud.
And I don't know about you, but when you've been freed of something,
yo no sé tú, pero cuando has sido liberado de algo,
when you've been captive to your sin for years,
cuando tú has sido un esclavo al pecado por años,
and you've been freed,
y tú has sido finalmente liberado,
you want to give God some glory and some
tú
praise.
Tú quieres darle a Dios gloria también.
And I believe that if you understand this treasure chest, the amount of blessings,
yo creo que si tú entiendes este baúl de tesoros y el número de bendiciones que hay allá adentro,
that God has given you,
que Dios te ha dado,
you will do great things for Him in His kingdom.
Tú vas a hacer cosas grandes para Él en su reino.
See, you're saved because He chose you.
Tú eres salvo porque Dios te escogió.
You're saved because He adopted you.
Tú eres salvo porque Él te adoptó.
You're saved because He accepted you.
Tú estás salvo porque Él te aceptó.
And you're saved because you're a child of God.
Y tú eres salvo porque tú eres un hijo de Dios.
But in verse 6, it blows me away.
Pero en el versículo 6, esto me anima mucho.
Because He says He has freely given us in the one He loves. You know, in the Greek,
él nos ha dado una gloria, gracia en Jesucristo.
Freely given actually means to be highly favored.
En el griego, el que nos hayan dado sí quiere decir que él te ha favorecido a ti.
So I want to encourage you this morning.
Yo te quiero animar esta mañana.
That when God looks down on you,
que cuando Dios te ve a ti,
you are highly favored.
Tú eres favorito para él.
Now I don't know about you, but when I feel highly favored,
yo no sé tú, pero cuando me siento como el favorito.
There's a confidence to me.
Hay una confianza que yo siento.
There's a little pep in my step.
Me animo, me siento mejor.
I walk a little bit higher.
Camino hasta más derecho.
I walk a little bit bolder.
A mano así como levanto hasta el pecho.
And I walk with power.
Y camino con poder.
Because I am highly favored before God. Deuteronomy chapter 7 verse 6.
Deuteronomio capítulo 6.
Says, for you are a people holy to the Lord your God. The Lord your God has chosen you out of all the peoples on the face of the earth to be His people and to be His treasured possession. The reason you are highly favored this morning is because God values you.
La razón por la que tú eres especial para Dios es porque Él tiene un
valor
para ti.
Because God treasures you.
Porque Dios te ve como un tesoro a ti.
And because Paul understood this, he gives this one sentence in the Greek.
Y porque Pablo entendió eso, nos da una oración en el griego.
202 words.
201 palabras en una oración.
Explaining.
Explicando.
And giving praise to God.
Y dándole alabanza a Dios.
You know, many of us.
Muchos
here,
de nosotros aquí.
No, the Bible commands you to do many things.
Sabemos que la Biblia nos llama a hacer muchas cosas.
The Bible calls us and commands us to attend worship service.
Nos llama que vengamos a los servicios de alabanza.
The Bible commands us to give our
nos
money.
Nos da el mandamiento de dar nuestro dinero.
The Bible calls us to obey.
Dios nos llama a obedecer.
The Bible calls you to pray.
Nos llama a orar.
The Bible calls you to make disciples of all nations.
La Biblia nos llama a ser discípulos de todas las naciones.
But when you offer God praise,
pero tú cuando le ofreces a Dios alabanza,
and when you understand the magnitude of the treasure chest,
y tú cuando entiendes la magnitud de ese tesoro,
God doesn't have to demand anything from you.
Dios no tiene que pedir más de ti.
Because you just give it to Him for who He is.
Porque tú estás dando por lo que es Dios.
And not just for what He gives.
Y no por lo que Él nos da.
You know, I want to share a story.
Quiero compartir una historia
that I heard this week.
Que escuché esta semana.
That really troubled my heart.
Que me dolió en el corazón.
And the story that I heard was about an elderly couple.
La historia que escuché fue acerca de una pareja de la tercera edad.
Who was found dead in their home.
Que los encontraron muertos en su casa.
And as the people, as the investigators came in,
cuando llegaron los investigadores,
and they found this elderly couple deceased in their room,
y vieron a esta pareja que había muerto,
they were in awe of what they had found.
Se sorprendieron por lo que había sucedido.
And as they searched through the house,
y cuando empezaron a buscar en la casa,
they found bags and bags of money.
Encontraron bolsas y bolsas llenas de dinero.
And it was interesting because when they did the autopsy,
era interesante porque cuando hicieron la autopsia,
they found the cause of their death.
Encontraron la razón de la muerte.
Was that they were malnourished.
Es que no habían comido suficiente. Se murieron de hambre.
This couple had all of this money.
Esta pareja tenía todo este dinero.
And yet they died malnourished.
Pero se murieron de hambre.
You know, many of us come to church weekly.
Muchos de nosotros venimos a la iglesia cada semana.
Many of us come struggling.
Muchos venimos a la iglesia
into God's church. Many of us come in hurt and spiritually.
Muchos venimos lastimados espiritualmente.
Many of us come in critical.
Muchos venimos de una forma crítica.
And yet we go week by week.
Pasamos semana y semana.
Failing to realize the riches that you have in your life.
Sin entender las riquezas que tenemos en nuestras vidas.
And you come into God's church malnourished.
Y al venir a la iglesia débiles.
And you come into church and you sit in these pews.
Y venimos a la iglesia y nos sentamos en esas sillas.
With that treasure chest sitting next to you.
Con ese tesoro al lado tuyo.
And you have the key.
Y tú tienes las llaves.
To open it.
Para abrirla.
And receive the blessings.
Y recibir las bendiciones de Dios.
And I can look at some of your faces.
Yo puedo ver algunos de tus rostros.
And see that you're anemic this morning.
Y ves que estás un poquito anímico.
And see that you are malnourished spiritually.
Y ver que te estás muriendo de hambre espiritualmente un poco.
And many of us probably have blamed a couple people in this church.
Y muchos de nosotros a lo mejor le
for your
malnourishment.
But Paul says when you understand
pero Pablo
that
dice,
treasure
cuando
chest,
tú entiendes el tesoro de Dios,
no one is at fault for you.
Nadie tendrá la culpa pero tú.
Being anemic.
Ese que estés anímico.
Because you failed to open the treasure chest.
Porque no has querido abrir esa ese tesoro.
I want to challenge us this morning.
Quiero, tengo un reto para ustedes esta mañana.
To make a list of treasures.
Que hagas una lista de los tesoros.
That God has given you.
Que Dios te ha dado.
In your walk.
En tu camino.
And when you write that list.
Y cuando escribas esa lista.
You better give God some praise.
Espero que le des a Dios una gran alabanza.
Point number two.
Punto número dos.
The treasure of Christ is worth everything.
El tesoro de Jesucristo lo vale todo.
The treasure of Christ is worth everything.
El tesoro de Jesucristo lo vale todo.
Turn with me to Philippians chapter 3.
Filipenses 3.
If there's anybody in the Bible,
si hay alguien en la Biblia,
who understood the treasure of Christ,
quien entendió el tesoro de Jesucristo,
it was Paul.
Fue Pablo.
Philippians chapter 3, verse 4.
Filipenses 3.
It says, if anyone else thinks he has reasons to put confidence in the flesh, I have more. Circumcised on the eighth day of the people of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew of Hebrews, in regard to the law, a Pharisee as for zeal, persecuting the church, as for legalistic righteousness, faultless. But whatever was to my profit, I now consider a loss for the sake of Christ. What is more, I consider everything a loss compared to the surpassing greatness of knowing Christ Jesus, my Lord, for whose sake I have lost all things. I consider them rubbish that I may gain Christ and be found in him, not having a righteousness of my own that comes from the law, but that which is through faith in Christ, the righteousness that comes from God and is by faith. I want to know Christ and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of sharing in his suffering, becoming like him in his death, and so somehow to attain the resurrection from the dead. Paul right here describes
Pablo aquí describe
all the things that he gave up for Christ.
Todas las cosas que él dejó por Jesucristo.
And Paul wasn't boasting about how awesome he was.
Y él no estaba presumiendo de lo increíble que él era.
He was making a point.
Él estaba haciendo un punto.
That he cared nothing about those things.
De que él no le importaban ninguna de esas cosas.
When he found the treasure of Christ.
Cuando encontró el tesoro de Jesucristo.
Paul was a scholar.
Pablo era un erudito.
And if Paul was with us today, he would have scholarships, diplomas, everything falling from his pocket.
Si él hubiera estado con nosotros, hubiera títulos y cualquier nombre que le hubieras querido dar.
Because he was highly educated.
Porque era una persona altamente educada.
He had an outstanding reputation.
Él tenía una increíble reputación.
He was gifted.
Él era un hombre con muchos regalos, tenía mucho talento.
He was skilled.
Él tenía muchas habilidades.
And he was admired.
Y era admirado también.
But one of the things that really opened up my eyes,
algo que me abrió los ojos,
that I never saw from this scripture,
que yo nunca había visto de esta escritura,
was in verse 8.
En el versículo 8.
He says, I consider everything a loss.
Yo considero todo una pérdida.
And I've squared this in my Bible. I've circled it.
Yo le hice un círculo eso en mi Biblia.
And I was like, everything means everything.
Y dice, todo significa todo.
But I looked again into the Greek language. And the Greek word for loss was damaged.
Y la palabra griega para la pérdida es estar lastimado.
All the things that Paul mentioned previously,
todas las cosas que tenía Pablo anteriormente,
he's basically telling us,
él está diciendo esto,
that all those things were damaging to his relationship
que
with
todas
Christ.
Las cosas que él tenía antes solamente lastimaban en su nueva relación con Jesús.
I gotta ask us this morning,
quiero preguntarte esta mañana,
what are you holding on to that's damaging
que tienes
your
todavía
relationship
en
with
tu vida
Jesus.
Que está lastimando tu relación con Jesús.
But then the next thing that Paul says,
a lo que dice después Pablo,
is he gave up everything that damaged him.
Él dio todo lo que le lastimaba en su relación con Jesús.
And it was nothing compared to the surpassing greatness of knowing Christ.
Nada se comparaba con la increíble experiencia de conocer a Jesucristo.
And Paul talks about, hey, I want to know Jesus deeply.
Y Pablo dice, yo quiero conocer a Jesús de una forma más profunda.
I want to know Jesus more intimately.
Yo quiero conocerlo de una forma más íntima.
In fact, I want to share in his suffering.
Es más, quiero yo compartir en sus sufrimientos.
That's deep.
Eso es algo profundo.
And I think a lot of us are shaking a little bit.
Yo pienso que algunos están pensando, ¿qué es eso, verdad?
Because we're asking ourselves the question.
Porque nos estamos haciendo una pregunta.
Do I have the same conviction?
¿Tengo yo las mismas convicciones?
But what I see from Paul here,
pero lo que yo veo aquí de Pablo,
is what I like to call,
es lo que yo, a mí me gustaría llamarle,
a holy passion.
Una pasión pura.
Now the word holy,
la palabra santa,
means set apart.
Significa estar escogido.
The word passion in Latin,
la palabra pasión en latín,
means suffering.
Significa sufrimiento.
What does this translate to us today?
¿Cómo se traduce esto hoy en día?
That Jesus' suffering was so set apart.
Que el sufrimiento de Jesucristo fue tan diferente, fue tan aparte de los
from
demás.
From any kind of suffering.
De cualquier otro sufrimiento que se había experimentado anteriormente.
So that you,
para que tú,
did not have to go and experience,
no tuvieras que experimentar
the same suffering,
el mismo sufrimiento
that he experienced,
que él pasó,
because of his holy passion for you,
por su gran pasión por ti.
But the question is, why do we start losing our drive for Jesus?
Pero la pregunta es, ¿por qué perdemos nuestro enfoque en Jesús?
It's simply because you no longer want to suffer.
Es simplemente porque tú ya no quieres sufrir.
And I found this to be true in my life.
Y me di cuenta que esto es cierto en mi vida.
Many times,
muchas veces,
in my walk with God,
en mi camino con Jesús,
in the past 8 years,
en los últimos 8 años,
of being a disciple of
de
Jesus,
ser discípulo de Jesucristo.
You know, on July 3rd of 2018,
el julio 3 del 2018,
about a year ago,
hace un año,
I was suffering.
Yo estaba sufriendo.
I was suffering with bitterness.
Estaba sufriendo por amargura.
I was suffering with faithlessness.
Falta de fe.
I was suffering with the feeling of loneliness.
El sentirme solo.
And I was suffering from the symptom
estaba sufriendo
of being
del síntoma.
A covetedness man.
De ser un hombre enfocado en mis compromisos.
And I found myself as I turned 7 years old spiritually.
Ya que tenía 7 años como discípulo.
On July 3rd of 2018.
En julio 13 del 2018.
I felt my love and my passion.
Sentí que mi amor y mi pasión.
For Jesus.
Por Jesucristo.
Starting to fade.
Empezó a caer.
And a day that is your spiritual birthday.
Y un día en el que es tu cumpleaños espiritual.
Should be one of the most fired up days you have that
uno de los días más animados en tu caminar con Jesús.
But for me it wasn't.
Pero para mí no lo fue.
Because I had lost sight.
Porque había perdido dónde estaba Jesús.
Of the treasure before me.
Del tesoro que estaba enfrente de mí.
But when I look at Jesus' sacrifice.
Pero cuando veo el sacrificio de Jesucristo.
I imagine Jesus saying.
Me imagino a Jesús diciéndome.
Aaron, you're worth it.
Aaron, tú vales la pena.
Danny, you're worth it.
tú vales.
Sheila, you're worth it.
Sheila, tú realmente vales.
Brenda, you're worth it.
Brenda, tú también vales.
Michelle, you're worth it.
Tú vales.
And I believe we got to ask ourselves the question.
Y tenemos que hacernos esa pregunta.
This morning.
Esta mañana.
Is Jesus worth it?
Si realmente Jesús vale la pena.
Turn with me as we close out to Jeremiah chapter 17.
Vámonos a Jeremías capítulo 17.
Jeremiah chapter 17.
Jeremías capítulo 17.
We're picking up in verse 5.
Versículo 5.
This is what the Lord says. Cursed is the one who trusts in man, who depends on flesh for his strength, and whose heart turns away from the Lord. He will be like a bush in the wastelands. He will not see prosperity when he comes. He will dwell in the parched places of the desert, in a salt land where no one lives. But blessed is the man and woman who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in him. He will be like a tree planted by the water that sends out its roots by the stream. It does not fear when heat comes. Its leaves are always green. It has no worries in a year of drought. It never fails to bear fruit. You know, when you rely on people to keep you faithful and motivated,
cuando tú confías en la gente para que te mantenga firme y motivado,
and to get you to church,
y para que te traigan a la iglesia,
you are not valuing,
tú no estás dándole el valor,
the treasure,
al tesoro,
chest of Jesus,
que Dios, Jesús nos ha dado.
But when you embrace the treasure of Christ,
pero cuando tú agarras el tesoro de Jesús,
and the treasure of Christ is worth everything,
y el tesoro de Jesús vale todo para ti,
you will continue to overflow.
Tú seguirás llenándote
for eternity.
Para la eternidad.
Family, I want to charge us this morning.
Familia, tengo un reto para ustedes.
To give God praise.
Que le den a Dios toda alabanza.
And to every day.
Y que todos los días.
As a disciple.
Como discípulos.
Open up that treasure chest.
Abramos ese baúl de tesoros.
To remind yourself.
Para que se recuerden.
Why you're a disciple.
Porque eres un discípulo
of Jesus Christ.
De Jesucristo.
I love you, and to God be the glory.
Y que a Dios sea toda la gloria. Amén.